Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel, Make It Make Sense. And we're going to be talking about a musician that actually died this year. It's sad to say that we always have to report the good with the bad. So we get this article from TMZ, and the artist that died, the musician artist that died, was called Gangsta Boo. And I never heard of this girl before. I heard of 3-6 Mafia. But then my daughter told me that what she was famous for was a song called Get Them Dollars, okay? So we got TMZ reporting that 3-6 Mafia, Gangsta Boo, dead at 43. Possible OD. It was exclusive for them. All right. It says 4:53 p.m. Pacific time. Sources connected to Gangsta Boo tell TMZ the rapper's death appears to be a drug-related or was drug-related. We're told that Gangsta was with her brother last night at a local concert in Memphis, and that her sibling started to overdose sometime in the night, requiring hospitalization. While he ended up being okay, our sources tell us that people familiar with Gangsta Boo's death scene insist narcotics were found on her person and that fentanyl-laced substance is believed to be at play. We're told the police are launching an official investigation. Now, for me to just insert myself in this one, we already know it's a stage thing. It may be connected to a ritual that needed to be performed at the beginning of the year, and she was one of the poor souls that fell victim to this. Now, it's just my conspiracy theorist mind overworking and overplaying, but that is just what I got from everything being blamed on these entertainers. Oh, they had an overdose. Oh, they were depressed. Oh, you know, just a whole lot of mess instead of what it really is. And it would showcase the music industry, the whole entire industry, as a bunch of fraudulent fakery going on with foolishness, okay? That's all I got to say. My 4 L's. Foolishness, fuckery, fraudulent, and fakery behavior. But going back to the article, it said while he ended up... Okay, no, she's okay. Stop it, JJ. They're saying an autopsy obviously needs to be done as well to see what the cause of death was. Well, you just told us it was... possible a drug overdose, did you not? That's what they're saying. That's what they're citing. But is that really the truth? Jaden, stop it. Play with that. Okay, then it says Lola Mitchell, aka Gangsta Boo, a former member of 3-6 Mafia and a pioneer of female rapper, has died. The hip-hop star passing was confirmed by her former label mate DJ Paul, who threw up a photo of her on Instagram, seemingly as a tribute. Several point artists commented with messages of condolences. The exact circumstances surrounding her death are unknown. Okay, we got Gangsta Boo's career officially started in the 90s when she linked up with Paul, Juicy J, and other founding members of the rap group, which included likes of Lord and Famous, Crunchy Black, and Kusta Nika, and more. Gangsta Boo was one of the only female rappers with the crew, but she held her own and paved her own lane for years as part of 3-6 Mafia. In addition to her own solo albums that she was cranking out at the time, Too Much Acclaim, Gangsta was also featured on 3-6 Mafia 5 studio albums, including their debut record in 95, Mystic Styles, as well as other notable projects like Chapter 1, When the Smoke Clears, and even the Choices album that served as a soundtrack to the movie. Okay? Gangsta Boo left 3-6 Mafia in the early 2000s, but went on to have a notable career thereafter, cranking out another solo studio album and several mixtapes through the rest of the aughts and 2010s. This, of course, does not include the countless features she's been a part of, working with rap titans such as Gucci Mane, Lil Jon, Outkast, E-40, T.I., The Game, and more. She continued rapping until the 2020s as well, often collaborating with Killer Mike and LP in their hip-hop duo Run the Jewels. Gangsta Boo is also continuing to partner up with different media outlets to put out music, such as Up Rock and others. Gangsta Boo was a staple in the Memphis community and music scene, and seems to have been beloved by the people there. She was active and on social media quite recently. She was 43 at her passing, and we say Godspeed, peaceful restings in heaven. And she was an all-around good rapper, I guess, more so, because I didn't really know anything about her. But we're going to let you listen to her, Get Them Dollars, and I was crooning. I was sitting up there snapping my hand, bopping my feet, you know, doing from the left to the right. She could do some things. I wonder why her and Left Eye didn't join up, or the Brat. Who else? Lakeem. Why they didn't get in the midst of her? I would have liked that collaboration. But this is what it is. And we'll leave you with Where Them Dollars At.
You know, when I left Memphis, Tennessee to go to New York, I was so scared. But one thing my mother always told me was to get them dollars.
Oh, hold on. Technical difficulties. Y'all know I'm under the weather. And still trying to make it do what it do. Oh, come on. All right, let's go back. Sorry about that, guys. Oh, wait a minute. Ah, oh, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Get that.
I left Memphis, Tennessee to go to New York. I was so scared. But one thing my mother always told me was to get them dollars. Cause your name be on my caller ID. I guess you can say I'm kinda crazy in my own ways.